Hello, everybody. I sure hope you had a very merry Christmas. I hope Christmas was all that you needed it to be, may not have been all you wanted it to be, but God really loves you, and I hope because you saw Him as the centerpiece of Christmas that you had a great one. Christmas is so fun that we just want to keep it going, actually. Even though Christmas is over in a sense, we can still have fun, right? We can still celebrate, right? So remember that we are still celebrating Jesus, God's greatest gift. Let's also remember that we have learned each week a different bottom line for each week. So week one, we learned from Isaiah 9:6, we can have hope because God keeps His promises. Week two was the news from the angel that brought great joy to who? Mary. And we learned that we have this great joy that can come to us. We learned that you can have joy because God has a plan for you from that story. Then just last week, we learned that God did something special. Read it with me. God loved us so much that He gave us a Savior. I hope you're excited to learn what today's bottom line is as we continue to celebrate Jesus being born. But as you know, it's time for Miss Pam and another fun game. So take it from here, Miss Pam.
Hello, everyone. I hope you had a great Christmas. What were some of your favorite things during this Christmas season? It can be something you did, maybe someone you got to see, even over Zoom, or a favorite gift. Think about it. I wish I could hear what you were saying right now. There's so much to love about Christmas, and the part I love the most is the reason we celebrate Christmas in the first place. Christmas is celebrating God, Jesus, God's greatest gift. God's greatest gift. He loves us so much that He sent His Son to be our Savior. When we remember that, we can have hope. We can have joy all year long, no matter what the circumstances. Even though Christmas is over, we're still celebrating around here. We know that Jesus is the greatest gift we could ever receive. Maybe some of these will be a close second. Check it out. Let's keep the fun going as we worship and sing to God together.
Well, thank you, Miss Pam, again for that fun game. Were any of those a close second to Jesus being born? Not at all, actually. Since he is the greatest of all time, he's the greatest of all time gift. He's the greatest of all time, let's sing about him being born in a manger. Have you ever been away from home and you really miss your own comfy bed? You know, Jesus was born away from the comfort of a nice home where Mary and Joseph were. They traveled to the city. There wasn't room in the inn. And he was born in a place where there just were other animals. And I'm sure both of them, Mary and Joseph, wished that it was different, that they weren't away from their home. But still, they had what they needed. That's the deal. They had what they needed to have this baby to come into the world. So let's sing and imagine what it must have been like for Jesus to be born away from home, away in a manger. This song has come with some fun motions with it, so I hope you get up and you sing and do the motions with this familiar Away in a Manger song. Did you have fun singing about Jesus being born, even though Christmas Day is already over? Because he can be born afresh and anew into each day of us. Like, Jesus, come and make it new today. even after Christmas, we can praise him. Let's actually read a psalm, Psalm 71:23, where it says, "My lips will shout with joy when I sing praise to you. You have saved me." So even after Christmas, we can still sing. Because God sent his son Jesus to be the savior of the world, the one who always brings joy into our lives. And we have been doing this song all month long, so you should know the words by now. And I hope you've learned some dance moves or made up some cool ones of your own. You can just make up those whenever, differently, however you want. Let's once again let Jesus bring joy into our world today, even today. Let's lift our voices and worship him now with this month's song. One last time.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let her receive her King. Let
of the year. I've been jingle belling, decking the halls, and going on all kinds of sleigh rides this season. And you want to know why? Because it's Christmas! Christmas is celebrating Jesus, God's greatest gift. I love this time of the year because everybody's nicer to everybody else and all the decorations, like the Christmas tree.
Christmas tree, oh Christmas tree.
Oh, and the stockings! I love you, stockings, and the lights, and everything's so beautiful. I love Christmas! Oh yeah, that's right. I gotta check out this big present over here. There's always something cool in this box every time I open it. Look how cool this box is. And there's something cool in it every time I open it.
Ooh, so excited.
It's empty. Oh man, I know why the box is empty. I just remembered. Christmas is over. Christmas. Can't believe it's over. No more decorations, no more lights, no more people being nice to each other. There's nothing left to celebrate. No, all that's left is to clean up, which is gonna take forever. And then you gotta go through all your gifts and sit down, and some of them require instructions, which means you gotta read, and then some of them have to come with batteries, so then you have to go sit in traffic to go to the mall to pick up some batteries, and that's just gonna be a giant waste of time. And breathe, Jacob. Breathe and smile through it. Or maybe there is something left to celebrate. In today's story, we'll find out what happened after Jesus was born. It's actually really good news. I got some decorations to clean up and a big empty box. Might as well get started. See you soon.
Hi guys. Well, I'm still gonna tell you Merry Christmas. I know it's after Christmas now, but we are into week 4 of December. And you know what? Now we're gonna really celebrate peace on earth because Jesus has come. Jesus is here to save us. So can you imagine being the shepherds that night out in that field when all the stars and all the angels appeared? Would you be filled with wonder? Would you be slightly a bit terrified? Yeah, me too. So today's story, I want you to look at it a little bit differently. I want you to have that wonder and that amazement that those shepherds had in that field that night. And I want you to hear this story. And I want you to think about how you can share God's love with others through the rest of the year. Okay, you guys ready? Let's go see what God has for us today. Here we go.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 through 20.
When Jesus was born, there were shepherds living near Bethlehem. These men and boys lived outside, keeping the sheep safe from wind and storms, and protecting them from wild animals. These shepherds were among the least important people you'd meet, living outside and preparing their lentil stew over a campfire.
You put enough salt in there?
I'll add more.
Now, we don't know how many shepherds were in the fields when Jesus was born, and we certainly don't know their names, but we'll call two of them Cyrus and Zach.
Don't you ever get bored? I'm bored.
Time moves slower than a snail with a limp out here. You get used to it, youngin'.
I'm hungry.
Yeah, just you keep stirring that stew. It'll be ready soon enough.
Being a shepherd was simple enough.
Keep your eyes open.
For what?
Number one, wolves. Number two, thorny brambles. Number three, ditches and ravines.
That's it?
That's it.
I'm still bored.
At that very moment, the shepherds were nearly blinded by a brilliant light.
Mutton and mashed turnips. What is that?
A brilliant angel appeared, towering before the shepherds.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news. It will bring great joy for all the people.
The shepherds gaped, unable to say a word. It seemed impossible that an angel would appear to lowly men like them.
Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Here is how you will know I am telling you the truth. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger.
The shepherds were just beginning to get their breath back when suddenly, it seemed like all of heaven opened up. A full angel choir appeared, filling the sky.
May glory be given to God in the highest heaven, and may peace be given to those he is pleased with on earth.
Then, just as quickly as they had appeared, the angels returned to heaven. The sky dimmed. Stars twinkled faintly once more. The shepherds stood staring at each other, their mouths hanging open.
Huh, Are you bored now, youngin?
No.
Well, then let's do this.
We could just go to Bethlehem, leave the sheep.
Number one, let's see this thing that's happened. Number two, especially since the Lord saw fit to tell us about it. Number three, get moving.
Yippee!
The shepherds hurried to Bethlehem, not stopping for rest until they saw a light glowing on the edge of town.
There.
Breathless, the shepherds knocked on the door. Boom, 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 boom. A woman opened it. She looked tired, but her face was glowing.
Ma'am, we've come to see the baby.
The baby? You know?
The angels told us.
Come right in. I want to hear the whole story.
Once inside, the shepherds were greeted with a familiar sight. Sheep, chickens, hay, and something less familiar. A tiny baby, tightly wrapped in strips of cloth, lying in the animal's feeding trough.
He's so little.
Would you like to hold him?
The rough shepherds took turns holding the baby, gently as a lamb.
The Messiah, the Lord.
Right here, with us.
When the shepherds finally left, dawn was breaking over the hills. The little town of Bethlehem was waking up.
Praise God.
He sent a savior, a Messiah.
Just a tiny baby now, but he's gonna make peace for all of us, everywhere.
Everyone who heard what the shepherd said was amazed, and Mary kept everything that had happened in her heart to think about over and over.
There we go. It's true. Christmas is over, but if you think about it, Christmas isn't just one day. No, Christmas is only the start of something bigger. Listen. When the shepherds heard Jesus was born, the first thing they did was get moving. They had to see for themselves. And when they found out that what the angel had said was true, they got moving again. And they told everyone about the baby they'd seen. And the good news they heard. And the angel said, it was good news for all the people, by the way. The news was this. In a world full of sadness and pain and fighting and anger and deep breath, God sent Jesus to bring peace. And the peace Jesus brings can help us get through all the stress and confusion and pain we might see in this world. That is good news. And you know what else is good news? That means the Christmas celebration doesn't have to end after just one day. There's still a lot left to celebrate. Yeah, baby, Christmas! We've gotta get moving. Like those shepherds, we gotta tell everyone the good news. People need to know this one thing. God's peace is for everyone. It's not something we keep to ourselves. So, maybe there won't be lights or decorations, but we can still be nice to one another. We can still give gifts to show people we love them. We can still sing and we can still celebrate. Boom! Christmas all year! Oh man, I am feeling much better now. The holidays are over, the decorations are in the box, and I am at peace. Still have got a lot of fake snow to clean up. I'll see you around. Merry Christmas! I'm making a bigger mess for myself.
Here we are at our time together we call lunch. What a great story today, right? The shepherds, they traveled and found Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus, who is lying in a manger. And nothing else in the whole world mattered at that point anymore. Because they had this experience of an angel that had a message, which is our remember verse, and then a bunch of angels singing. How would you react? Can you imagine how that must have felt? One minute you're hanging out with a bunch of sheep on a hillside, and then you get this visit from an angel and then a bunch of angels telling you the best news ever? And then you run like crazy to find that it's true, it's real, God has sent his son to be the savior. And then after the shepherds saw Jesus, they told others what the angels had said about this child. They couldn't wait to share God's message of peace with everyone they knew. And I hope that you and your family have some great discussion about how you personally can each share God's message of peace with others because he's been born into your lives. The Remember Verse is a message for everyone, not just for those shepherds. So say it with me one more time. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord, Luke 2:11. And we sure hope you keep well this winter, but remember most of all how important it is to follow this Savior, Jesus, every day. He's the one that wants to bring peace into the world even today, through you. He wants you to speak peace and his truth to others. We celebrate him as the greatest gift that keeps giving, and so keep that going. Are you excited to see our theme for January? I am. Here it is. It's rules for life. Play well, finish strong. We're learning all month about responsibility. What does that mean? It's showing you can be trusted with what is expected of you. We are really excited to do this new theme all month of January. It's a new year, and we're excited to share this new theme, Rules for Life. Miss Karen, Miss Pam, and I, we love you. I can't tell you enough that truth, and we pray for you every week. And we will see you next week. But for now, watch this Dear God video.
Dear God, you know I love Christmas. Always have, always will. But let's face it, every year it gets too busy, and it can be a lot for us to handle. Too many places you have to go, too many things you have to do, and there's always something unexpected that happens. Plus, there's all the gifts you have to find, and wrap, and deliver. It gets kind of crazy. I mean, it's all good stuff, but it can just wear you down. I think Mom was feeling that. She just wanted to make this a really special Christmas. It's been a tough year. Anyway, I was reading about how you invented the whole Christmas thing. The baby, your son, born in a barn with really nothing. I mean, my friend told me that the wise men didn't even bring the presents until later. It all seemed, well, simple. A lot more simple than we make it. That's when I had the idea. I thought she would never make it home. Mom looked really surprised. God, thanks for Christmas. Please help me and Mom to remember that it's all about you and how much you love us and that it's okay not having everything perfect. Help me to show love to other people that same way. Merry Christmas, God. Love, Ellie.